Bloomin' Marvellous now on BBC Two. It's more from Cat's Eyes. Alf's a keen gardener, always pottering away, though he's not got green fingers, like Katie. In fact, when it comes to flowers, seeds and plants, Alf's got quite a bit to learn.
Hey, Jimmy, why is Alf pulling up all those plants?
Must be collecting ingredients for his latest pizza.
What, dandelion thistle and stinging nettle pizza?
Well, it's cheaper, isn't it? You don't get pepperoni and tuna fish growing in the corners of the alley now, do you?
How are you this morning?
Oh, fine, fine, you know, mustn't grumble.
You're so pretty, you brighten up the whole alley.
Well, you're not looking too bad yourself.
I wasn't talking to you, Alf.
Well, who were you talking to then?
The flowers, of course.
But they can't hear you, they don't have any ears.
I know. I just think plants grow better if you speak to them nicely. There, that's enough watering. I've got to get down to the shops and buy a box of chocolates.
Chocolates? Really, Katie? You should have more than that for lunch. What about a pizza?
They're not for lunch, Alf. In fact, they're not for me at all. They're for my mum. Oh. It's Mother's Day tomorrow. Or had you forgotten?
Forgotten? Certainly not. And that's why I've put together this very spectacular bunch of flowers. Ah, impressive, eh? Now, should they be in a vase, do you think?
No, they should be in a dustbin. You can't give her those.
Why not? They're flowers, aren't they? Look, there's a yellow one, there's a mauve one.
Yes, but they're just not the sort that your mum might want. Flowers are meant to be special, Alf.
Check out the tulip and the daffodil, and you'll see what's special about flowers.
Mmm!
How they lend a splash to a windowsill.
Gosh, that smell just overpowers.
Check out the beauty of the rose. It's soft and scented petals.
You'd hardly want to stick your nose in a bunch of stinging nettles.
If you're looking for a way to banish gloom, to brighten every day like tower, you can't beat a beautiful plant in bloom.
You can't beat a beautiful flower.
Where the flower plant is, look at me in my brand new springtime gear. And the bugs and the birds and the bumblebees all magically appear.
So if you're looking for a way to banish gloom, to brighten every daylight hour, you can't beat a beautiful plant in bloom. No, you can't beat a beautiful flower.
Plants are beautiful, but they're not just there to be looked at. They've got their uses too. Some flower, whilst others grow delicious fruit.
Here in Jamaica, there are plants everywhere. They even grow on the electricity wires.
Jamaica's the perfect place for plants to grow, as there's lots of sunshine and plenty of rain. And the Jamaicans put their plants to some amazing uses.
Where are we going, Peter?
Oh, well, you know how Jamaicans are very clever. They find a use for just about everything, okay? Well, here I'd like you to meet two people who are going to point out all sorts of strange plants to you and tell you exactly what they're good for, whether it be medicines or food or just for making all sorts of strange things.
Okay, let's go.
All right, come on.
Well, dog.
Yo, Willie.
What do I
have here,
man?
Oh, I'm Willie.
Yeah.
Hi, Willie.
This is Femi. Come all the way from England to learn about plants.
Hi.
And you know, I know you can show us.
Yeah, we have it here to show us.
Yeah, man. Come on, let's go.
We have it here to show us.
What can you see over there?
Willie uses plants as medicines. He's 55 years old and he's never had to visit the doctor. In fact, many of the medicines we take are made from plants. You just have to know what to look for. Pick the wrong plant and it can be very dangerous. He was obviously a very fit 55-year-old. He was firing those mangoes out of the tree so fast I could hardly keep up.
Strong back.
Yeah, you dig it.
Will he show me one of his medicine plants? Apparently, its roots can cure a sore back.
Good for the back.
By the way, Quinn, is there anything here that's good for warts?
And squeezing the redhead plant can cure your warts.
You sweat it up clean like soap.
To make the suds.
Yes.
And there's even a plant that washes you clean when you rub it. A soap plant. But it's not just medicines and soaps that plants can make. Plants are really good to build things with too, especially if they're really tough, like the bamboo.
We use bamboos to make like furnitures and whistles,
stuff like that.
You make bamboo things, don't you?
Yeah.
What have you got?
I got a violin. My pocket organ.
Right here? I know that one. It's my favourite song. They smell beautiful.
But maybe the best thing Jamaicans do with the plant is to eat its fruit.
Jamaican mango time now. Yeah, mango time in Jamaica. They're very nice and smell very good.
This one's lovely.
Well, okay.
Willie, what is that?
Soursop.
Soursop.
2 days time it ripe. 2 days.
Willie told me that if you take the prickles off, the fruit would be ready to eat within 2 days. And then the best part of the day, Willie's speciality, making fruit drinks.
Squeeze the juice out.
Yeah.
It's got water in.
And you strain it like this.
I really enjoyed my adventure to Willie's secret world of plants, and the drinks he made were cool and refreshing. Cheers, Willie.
Very nice.
This is lovely.
Oh, nice, nice, can be.
There we are. Nice drop of water.
You know what? Katie's bloomin' crazy.
Mind your language, Jimmy.
No, I mean she's crazy about bloomin'. When flowers burst open like that, it's called blooming.
Oh, yes. You know, they're funny things, flowers. I mean, have you ever seen a flower lie down and go to sleep?
No, why?
Well, what do they need flower beds for, then?
Hi, Al. Have you got some flowers for your mum yet?
Yep, I've come up with the perfect solution. I was in the kitchen, and it suddenly came to me. A bunch of really big, bold flowers to show her how much I love her.
Sounds great. Can I see them?
Yep, I was just wrapping them up in a bouquet.
Oh, Al.
Shut your eyes, Katie, and wrap your nostrils round these. The perfume, you could bottle it.
Cauliflowers? Try again, Al.
What's wrong? They're flowers, aren't they?
Cat's eyes.
After a plant has flowered, it can bear fruit. This speeded up film shows what happens when the flower dies and the fruit grows.
Hi, your fruit looks good today. What have you got?
Oh, I got some delicious mangoes.
They are big as well.
Yeah, they're very nice.
When I was in Jamaica, I saw all sorts of unusual fruit. The roadsides were just dotted with fruit stalls packed with fruit of every shape and size. My favourite was the watermelon. But all the fruit had one thing in common. They all had seeds inside them.
If I plant this seed, it could grow into more watermelons. In fact, most fruit want you to eat them so you can spread their seeds.
Seeds grow into plants. From the seed grows a stem to help the plants to stand up. And under the soil, a maze of roots grow that allow the plant to drink. And leaves start to sprout. It must have been a pretty big seed this coconut tree grew from. I wonder if the coconut itself was the seed. Collecting coconuts is quite difficult, as they grow right at the top of the tree and they like to hide under enormous leaves. It took someone with real skill to bring those coconuts down.
Peter, is he going to be okay?
Yes, ma'am. Piece of cake. Do it all the time.
I had never eaten coconut this fresh before. Inside there was sweet water.
My mother told me never to slurp.
And when the coconut was cut in half again, there was soft white flesh inside.
I have to eat this now.
Okay.
Alright.
Mmm! That's like coconut jelly.
Nice. That's exactly what it is.
How come it's not, this coconut isn't brown?
Well, that I've got to show you. I'll show you a brown one.
Hold on there, Mr. Binns. I want Femit to see this.
All right. If this stays on the tree long enough, it will become like one of these.
Okay. So this one's dried up, yeah? Uh-huh.
Okay, but still not ready. We have to do that first.
All right.
Okay, go ahead, Mr. Binns.
We're spilling the shell off. Mm-hmm. Spilling off the last bit of shell there.
It takes a bit of skill to do that, though, yeah?
Okay.
Here you are.
Thank you, Mr. Binns. That's what I know as a coconut.
Okay, now, if you didn't take this out of this...
Okay.
This would eventually become a little coconut tree.
Really? Mm-hmm. How's that happen?
All right. Come over here, I'll show you something.
Okay.
Yes. You place this in a nice, warm, damp place until... it sprouts like this. You take it where you want it, plant it, and it grows into a tree.
So the coconut grows from a seed, just like all the exotic plants found in this tropical paradise.
Oh, there you are, Al. Have you been to see your mum yet?
Just on my way.
Did you get her something?
Yes.
Well, let's see then.
Yes, oh,
Al, you bought her a proper bunch of flowers.
Well, yes.
There's no need to be embarrassed. That's really sweet and thoughtful of you. They're lovely. Hang on a minute.
Well, anyway, I better be off.
I recognise those flowers from somewhere. Why, you!
Al's going to get another bunch in a minute. A bunch of pies when Katie catches up with him.
Why does she need that flower pot, Jimmy?
I think she's going to do some planting.
Planting?
Yeah, she's going to plant it on Al's head.
Meow! Where the flower planters look at me in my brand new springtime gear. And the bugs and the birds and the bumblebees all magically appear.
So if you're looking for a way to banish gloom, to brighten every daylight hour, you can't beat a beautiful plant in bloom. No, you can't beat a beautiful flower.